All right, I want to use this camera as a vlogging camera. Okay.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I'm in the backyard with the EOS R. I want to use this camera as a vlogging camera because I think a lot of people are going to grab onto this because you get 4K and you get it in a Canon camera with all the wondrous colors. So, what lens do I have on here? I'm going to pick you up. Okay, I do have image stabilization on, but only in the lens. I don't have it on in the camera because it makes the image soft and unacceptable. So the lens is the 10 to 18 4.5. Who the heck came up with that kind of crap? EFS lens. Walking in the background. I got a mic on top of the camera. And I'm set at 10 millimeters. And yes, I am shooting 4K. I don't trip over that hole. All right, so what do we got? The camera is not too heavy, but it's not too light. It definitely has a white box around my face as I'm walking. I'm going to change hands a little bit, not because I had to, but I will when I have to. We got jingle bells down there. See, the 10 by 18 is a very wide lens, especially since this has a crop. But the crop is becoming less important and getting the actual images out and getting the actual product done is becoming more and more important. And my hair is flying like crazy. It's windy, it's overcast. I set the white balance, I forgot. I set the white balance to cloudy because I don't want the auto white balance to go up and down, up and down, up and down. And I'm using the right white, which you can get down below. They're still free, I think. So grab them while they're available. I'm giving the whole lot away for free. The first one. So that's what we got going. So this, I think, is going to become the new vlogging camera. I got it on a Joby tripod. And I'm holding the tripod so I can hold the camera higher. Because this lens is so wide, I actually can come in closer. I don't have to be so far. That makes it easier on my elbow. Okay. I was going to show you jingles, but guess what he's doing? It isn't number one. It's the other one, which is very welcome because, you know, we don't want accidents and stuff like that. So this is what the walk around in the backyard looks like with the EOS R in 4K. I got a Canon camera and I'm shooting in 4K in my backyard while I'm walking around. Why didn't I have this 4 years ago? I don't know. That's Canon for you. So, what else can I tell you? Oh, let's go in the door over here, because I knew that dog was going to start barking. He loves me, and I guess he barks. Jingles, are you done? Come on, let's go inside, buddy. All right, so let's come in. This was the walk around. This is what the camera looks like as a regular little vlogging camera. I think it did a good job. And I'll be able to tell when I get inside and I grade it a little bit. Jingles, you coming? I keep forgetting I can bring this camera closer because I'm so used to having it, you know, so far away. All right, let me put it down here and give me a chance to set it up. So it's going to be bumpy for you. All right, so now we are at 10 millimeters on this 10 by 10 to 18, 4.5 to 5.6. I got an external microphone on the top. I'm shooting in 4K. I told you about the white balance. I'm shooting in TV mode because I want the shutter speed to be 1/60th of a second because I'm shooting in 30p. And this is what the camera looks like for you guys that want to see, that want to use it as a vlogging camera. So you can just set it down. Lewis, you can do your dancing. Doc, you can do your endo work. Justin, you could do your barbecuing out in the backyard. Osvaldo, you could do the weddings. Actually, Osvaldo's out on a wedding today. I know he's doing video, but I don't know if he's doing video and pictures because he does both. He's up in the northeast area. And what else? Can't think of anything else, so this is just going to be a short video. Oh, let me show you the 10 to 18 with me behind the camera now. Okay, let's go over here. I gotta make a video and show you. Let's use the front. All right, so I'm hand-holding it. So this is 10 millimeters. Now I'm slowly turning it, And that's the full strength, that's 18. So this is 10, and this is 18. So what does 18 look like when it's aiming back towards me? I don't know. Let's put it back over here. All right, so this is 18 millimeters. Set the camera down. All right, so, and it's crooked. Sorry. Does it feel like the boat's leaning? All right, so that's 18 millimeters, which is the lens's full strength, which means I am now up at f5.6, but I am outdoors. Over cloudy day, the sun is not, it's peaked out a few times. So that's what we've got, and let's move it back and go back to 18. And now there's 18. Now, I like my head being towards the top of the frame, especially when you're short like me. I'm 5'4". I look really tall in the videos, right? But in real life, I'm short, but tall in stature. How's that? So the way, you know, a lot of people will put their face like right in the center. No, that's not how you video, or even pictures. You want your head up near the top. Okay, I was just gonna go put the card in the computer, but I figured why not take a few feet of video in the Christmas room. All right, I'm under the light. I'm using the right white again because this is a different light. I switched the white balance to, what did I do? I put it to tungsten because the bulbs I'm using here are 2700K. So this is what it looks like. Same lens, 10 to 18, 4.5 to 5.6, and now I'm at 18. So 10 is too wide in here. So this 10 to 18 lens seems to be a very good match to go along with the EOS R. ISO is set to what? It's set to auto ISO. Same thing as the outside. So I basically have the camera in TV mode, which is shutter priority, because I want the shutter to stay at 1/60th of a second. So when I get this into the computer, I'm going to use the right white. I did that already. Okay, sorry, I forgot. I'm going to use the right white, and I'm going to color correct this. I'm also going to sharpen it because with the Canon, most Canon bodies, the R included, has an AA filter. So you're going to do your normal sharpening, but you also have to start by sharpening to neutralize the AA filter, and then you go to your regular sharpening routine. If you don't do that, the camera is going to look softer than other cameras that have no AA filter in them. The Panasonic, well, a lot of them, most of them don't have AA filters. So that's why I have a dual punch sharpening. I'm going to make a video, I think, on my processing, everything that I do processing in the computer. Anyway, I'm rambling. I wanted you to see what this looks like. Obviously, I just put the Joby tripod. I set it on a, what is it? It's a box. And I just came in front of it. I had to move it all the way to 18 because 10 was just too wide. You got to see the walls in the computer. So even at 4K, the 10 to 18 is, it really packs a punch. So at 10 to 18, at 10, this becomes a 17 millimeter. So at 18, it looks like it's becoming more like a 24 millimeter. You guys do the math because I'm not thinking. And let's see. Yeah, there's a white box right around me. You want me to do the forward and the back? Isn't that cool when everybody does that? I'm just sitting on a chair so that I don't move around, because I don't want to topple the camera. It's not on a tripod, it's on a box. So that's it. This is the Canon EOS R. I'm definitely warming up more and more to the camera when I see these other videos that are saying, oh, it's so soft, and oh, it's so this, and oh, a 1.7 crop, how terrible. I'm going like, if I owned this camera, I would be really, really happy. You know, it has a 1.7 crop, get over it. All right, if you need to full frame, I can understand how you would skip this camera. All right, but you don't mean everybody in the world. You're just you. So if you need to full frame, go for a full frame. If you don't need a full frame, by golly, this camera is awesome. There's a few things on this camera that really tick me off. I'm going to make a video on things I don't like about the EOS R, but not in this one. I'm going to put the camera back on the tripod and put the 35mm L lens on there, which is a $1,600 lens, but that's what this camera needs because it is got a really good quality sensor. So if you're going to get all the goodness and all the juice, don't go putting the cheap lenses on here. So this lens is an EFS lens. So you can mount the EFS lenses. You can mount the regular, this is not one of those lenses. Here's a Canon 50mm. This is a Canon 50mm 1.8. This lens is $130 or $100, somewhere in that range. This is look at how light. It almost wants to float up. I have to hold it down because this lens wants to float up. All right, you can even put this guy on there. This is the f1.2 L lens, and this is like a piece of jewelry. You need to put this on a ring and put it on your finger. Okay, that's just a beautiful lens. So, and I've got the 24mm, art lens, the 1.4 from Sigma. All of those would go on here because I've got the adapter. All right, camera's getting more and more exciting. You know, be careful what you hear, and in testing circumstances. I saw Max's tests with the different cameras. That was a lot of work that he did. I mean, I really got to hand him kudos. However, the test results, if you're just going for the sharpest kid on the block, then that would be your priority. Then you'll have to give up other things, okay? This camera is perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with it. There is nothing that's going to make it look like it's, yes, there is. If you activate the image stabilization inside the camera, I find that you get a much duller picture. And also, if you put cheaper lenses, you get a duller picture. If you don't sharpen properly, remember, this has got an AA filter. The A7 R3, where is it? Not the R. I don't have the R3. I just have the A7 III. Doesn't have an AA filter, and that camera is sharper. That camera is always going to be sharper. Do you know why? The only one that competes with it is the Panasonic. Now, the reason that the A7 III, all the A's on the Sonys, is they shoot in 6.5K, not 4K. They shoot in 6.5K and then sample it down, reduce it down to 4K. So you're going to get a much sharper picture by doing that. The high-end Canon Cinema series, that is the, which camera is that? The C100. The C100 shoots in 4K, but you never get to touch that 4K. It samples it down to 1080, so it's much sharper. Now, this camera could have done that, and Canon chose not to. Panasonic does. Panasonic shoots in 5.5K on their GH series and the G9, and will sample it down to 4K. Voila, a sharper picture. This one is one for one on the 4K. And no, it is not upsampled. I mean, come on, give me a break. This is 4K. So anyway, that's what we got going here. Time to end this video again. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. See you in my viewfinder.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.
Okay, let's do a little bit of handheld with Jingles. With all my little shaky. Hi, Jingles. Yeah, there's a white box around you. And you can give me a paw. Don't act like you're half asleep. This is Jingle Bells time. Jingle Bells. Jingle Bell time. Now there's a white box just around his body. It's a slender, tall, white box. Let's try the zoom. Oh, we're zooming out. Zoom out and zoom in. Okay, this is a 10 millimeters. Okay. And then I'm going to move it up to 18 millimeters, and that's obviously changing the f-stop because this is an f4.5 to 5.6. Now I'm going to make use of the articulating screen. Let's see if I can keep him while I'm changing my hands here. And I want to go down low. Wow, Jingle Bells, why are you ignoring me? Why are you ignoring me? People want to see you. Yes, they do, they want to see you. So we'll pretend you're a car. This is the front end of the car, and this is handheld. We'll go around. Whoops, I bumped into the couch. Okay, the white box is staying right on his head because I tapped on the screen. And there you have it. Now I just hit the bottom of the Joby tripod. Hey, baby. Come here. Say hi to Peter. Yeah, say hi to Peter. Nope, I had to move it to 10. Whoops. You want to give me that paw? Do you want to give me the paw? Give me the paw. Hey, come over here. In your basket. Okay. Give me the paw. Okay, give me the other paw. That's it. We are at the whitest. Okay. Here we go. He's looking. He wants to smell that lens. Yes, he does. Whoa, look at the mouth. I never filmed you inside your mouth. No, I never did. You're making me hit the tripod legs. All right, there you got it. We had a Jingle Bell time, didn't we? We had a Jingle Bell time. Zipping. Zipping.